We now take you live to Bangalore, where ISRO Chief K. Sivan is addressing the press.
And first, let me welcome Dr. K. Sivan, Chairman ISRO, for raising this occasion and for conducting this first meet on a special day, New Year's Day. And welcome to you, sir. And I also welcome Scientific Secretary ISRO, Sri Uma Maheshwaran, sir. Okay. And welcome, sir, once again. And I also welcome Sri Vivek Singh, Director, Office of Media and Public Relations, Mr. Okay. Thank you very much. First, I request Chairman ISRO to kindly brief you for a while, and followed by the questions from the media, interactions with the media. Kindly identify yourself as well as your media house before asking the question. I sincerely request you. And when one question is complete, then only as other person should raise the hand and everybody will get the opportunity. Thank you very much, sir. Please.
Good morning. All my friends from media. And also, that is, first of all, let me wish a happy New Year to all of you. Yes, we are meeting after a long time. I thought that it is my duty to meet you on the first day itself. At least our aim is to tell you what really we have achieved in 2019. And what we are targeting for 2020, that is our aim. And if you are seeing that 2019, our strategy mainly was to expansion program. We wanted to expand the ISRO horizontally. That is my name, first strategy we adopted. And the second strategy we adopted in 2019 was the capacity building and outreach program. These are the second target we aimed for 2019. And the third one is reduction of the physical work in the ISRO and how to make industry to get into the loop. That is the third part. Fourth part is mainly the development and conventional launches and other things. There's new developments. That is the fourth part. And in this one, if you see this Gaganyaan, we have a good progress in 2019 Gaganyaan. And many of the designs were completed. And astronauts have, the selection process is over. Now, the four astronauts identified for training purpose. That process also completed. Now the training for these four astronauts will be planned in the third week of January of this year. That is a Gaganyaan. Another one is a major development in Gaganyaan was we have constituted Gaganyaan Advisory Council, that committee, that in the national level committee, and we had the first review. And if you are having that the capacity building and expansion program, if you are seeing, lot of progress have happened in 2019. One major thing happened was, apart from the spaceport at the SDSC Shore, the land acquisition for a second spaceport is initiated. And this spaceport is going to be in Thoothukudi district of Tamil Nadu. And why this particular location was selected was mainly to get advantages of southward launch, especially for SSLV launch. This land acquisition process has been started. That is one a capacity building program. And second one is that is we have started the second vehicle assembly building is inaugurated to enhance the number of launches, and that first the launch pad activity for enhancing launch pad launch thing also has happened. That is the one thing. And we have established a public viewer gallery in the SDSC shop, mainly to for the public to see the launch that happens. That the thousands of, if I remember correctly, around 29,000 people have already has seen the launch. This one as per the record till now, and this every launch, this number of viewers are increasing. And another one, a major thing happened was that we want to expand the ISRO horizontally. Mainly, we wanted to establish the research and development required for ISRO where the ISRO centers are not there. So that way, we established, we are planned to have that 6 incubation centers, 6 the research centers. Out of that, the 3 incubation centers are established already, and very soon 3 more incubation centers we will be able to complete. Similarly, that is the 4 regional research academic centers are established. Remaining 2 will be done very soon. So that way, we are expanding that our horizon of the activities. That is the one part. Another one is that is we brought that the children, the high school children to ISRO to make them to train them for 2 weeks on the space science and technology, so that they will be having a better knowledge about that one, so that they can, it will be useful for their planning their science and the technology development for future of their activities. And another major activity we initiated, and it is going to come, is we want PSLV to be produced by industry. So for that, the first step of that 5 PSLV is planned to the realize by industry. That activity is going on. That is a new, our PSU, that NCIL is working on this one to meet. And regarding the launch vehicle and the satellite area, what we did is that we have 6 missions of launch vehicle and 7 missions of satellite. And most importantly, the PSLV has completed 50th launch, the last launch, that is the one. And we have introduced 2 new variants of PSLV. Another major interesting aspect what we did last year was we have made PS4 as a experimental platform after it's injected its satellite. That is the one. And Vikram processor, indigenous Vikram processor, realized in SCL Chandigarh. It is the flight tested and flight proven. That is a major achievement. And we have Cartosat 3 and 2 RISAT also we have made. And we have made a good progress in the Chandrayaan 2. And even though we could not land successfully, soft landed the Chandrayaan, the orbiter is still functioning. It is going to function for next 7 years. To produce science data, and the science meet for the Chandrayaan data also, it is being now conducted, and a lot of people are doing the work on that. And another major achievement or improvement happened was that international body 3GPP has approved our NAVIC to be inducted in the mobile. So very soon, all our mobiles are going to have that NAVIC also, along with the GPS. This is going to happen. Now, having completed what in my opinion, whatever we promised or whatever we targeted that we could achieve in the 2019, and what is 2020? One major announcement I wanted to make here officially is Chandrayaan 3 is government has approved, and it is that the project is now formed. The activity is going on Chandrayaan 3 very smoothly, and Chandrayaan 3 configuration will be almost similar to Chandrayaan 2. Only thing is, in that that Chandrayaan 2 we had orbiter, lander, rover configuration. Here this orbiter already functioned, will be used. So Chandrayaan 2 will be having mostly a lander and rover and with a propulsion module. So this we are we have initiated this project, and work is going on very smoothly on Chandrayaan 3. Another major new thing, so this year is going to be year of Chandrayaan 3 and Gaganyaan, I would say. And another major new thing is going to happen this year is we are going to have the maiden flight of SSLV, the small satellite launcher, in this year. And we are going to have the first flight of the GSLV with the 4-meter payload fairing, OJ payload fairing. This is going to happen this year, and which is required for our later missions like NICER, this one. And GSAT-20 is another satellite this year is planned. This is going to have that in-flight connectivity and maritime connectivity. And we are going to have our indigenous atomic clock in the navigation satellite. So IRNSS 1J with the indigenous atomic clock, it's going to be, we are targeting. Then Indian data relay system, satellite, IDRSS, which is essential for Gaganyaan. That also going to happen. And like that, many, many targets, and Aditya L1 mission, then Exposat, the X-ray polarimeter satellite with two payloads, everything is going to happen this year, this one. Along with a couple, another some 10, 15 satellites, conventional satellites for Earth observation and communications also will be launched this the next year. This year. And another one major thing we are going to do in Gaganyaan is, the Gaganyaan is that many the systems now need to be tested before flight. That is the flight that is a human rating of the propulsion modules. That is the testing is required, and a crew escape system test. For that, the test vehicle and the system, which is like airdrop test. So many tests for that is required, that we are planning this year. And crew training is another major activity this year is going to happen. That is one. And when we are going to realize the thing, and at the same time, that is we are targeting for our first unmanned mission very soon. At the earliest, we are targeting. The work is going on. It's going to be major part of the work will be done this year, Gaganyaan activity. So what I am telling is, just like the last year, this year also going to be eventful year for ISRO, and we are planning to do all the major projects, new developments, new projects, and at the same time, that is launching the satellites required for our societal purpose also planned this one. These are things now planned this year. So these are things I just wanted to brief to you. Now, if you have any question, maybe you can ask.
Kindly identify yourself. First, okay, Mr. Just one. Yeah, you can. Kindly identify. Mike, please. Mike. One by one. Everybody will get the chance. Please. Kindly go. Yeah. Identify, please.
Rajiv Mishra from Rajasthan. Wish you a very happy new year, sir. You mentioned about the Chandrayaan 3 project, but it is important to know what went wrong with Chandrayaan 2. Actually, we have seen many reports and we have read it, but we want to listen from you actually what went wrong with Chandrayaan 2.
See, what really happened in the Chandrayaan 2 was, in the power descent phase, this phase contains four phases. One is that the rough braking base, it is a major phase. That time, it went all, everything was all right. And second phase is, there's a camera coasting phase. In that phase, what really happened was that the velocity was not reduced, the amount supposed to be reduced. So the velocity reduction, it was more than whatever required to be done. So next phase, what happened was this particular, the large reduction in this velocity was not able to handle by next phase, because of this was beyond the design limit of the navigation guidance and control system. So which was not able to take care of that one, so finally it ended up with a hard landing, this one.
One more question I would have. Last year, ISRO targeted more than 300 missions. And I think we have ended up at 14 or 15 like that. And the focus was on Chandrayaan 2 from June to September. My question is, does it affect the capacity building of operation satellite program, as you mentioned? And once again, we are targeting ISRO this year. So, what kind of effect it has on the operation?